Let's discuss one of the most useful squatting variations that there are. That is the bodyweight squat. Why is it useful? Well, the squat pattern is a great mobility test, something that you want to hang on to, these movements that you want to hang on to all throughout your life. And it requires no equipment, and that's beautiful. No setup time at all. It's great. Now, if I'm doing a bodyweight squat, that can be enough load for somebody who's just starting working out. Some of my people, I don't even want them doing a bodyweight squat. I want them doing something supported. Maybe they put their hands on a bench and they squat down. Maybe they grab TRX straps and try to hold themselves up a little bit to make them unweighted. All of these variations are good, but let's say you have this base level of strength, base level of endurance, and you want to give the bodyweight squat a shot. So what am I looking for? I'm looking for feet about shoulder width. I'm going to come down. I'm going to come up. I like to just reach forward at the bottom, or even just bring my elbows forward at the bottom, like I'm holding something in front of me. If you've seen the goblet squat, this kind of mimics that position, but it doesn't have the external load that you're holding in your hands. From a stability standpoint, the bodyweight squat is actually more difficult than a goblet squat. The goblet squat holds more weight. There is more weight demand. And if your muscles do not contract, you'll find that more difficult. But if you're a stiff person and you have trouble controlling the positions of your body, the bodyweight squat is actually more difficult because the goblet squat with the weight in front of you, or a plate squat with the weight in front of you, gives you more feedback. It tells your body, this is the position that I'm in, and I hear it loud and clear. Okay, the goblet or the bodyweight squat, you have to kind of figure that out on your own. So from the front, again, I just kind of reach forward like this. From the side, I reach forward like this. Big things I'm looking for, don't let the weight shift forward, okay? Don't let the knees collapse in. From the side, don't let the weight shift forward. Don't let the heels come up off the ground, and don't let the knees collapse in. You'll see that those two mistakes kind of look very similar, but they are the most common, and sometimes you'll have to fix them both at the same time to get something that you're looking for. In general, you just want to think, my feet are flat, like tree roots, stuck firmly in the ground, and I'm going to squat down, and I'm going to squat up. The second big thing, we talked about falling forward, we talked about knees coming in. Don't let your butt stick way out like this, okay? I want you to sometimes set up with an exhale, keep your hips tucked underneath your body, and then keep your ears, your shoulders, your midsection, your butt in line as you bend over. Okay, you see how when I stick my butt out too far, my butt is way behind that line and my back starts to bend a little extra. I cracked my fingers doing that. My back starts to bend a little extra. I want it to feel like your back is just a plank, a big piece of wood, and you're holding that position the whole time. Okay, don't look down. Don't look too far up. Look kind of horizontally as you're doing this. If you have any other specific questions, feel free to go through all my videos about fixing your squat. They all pertain to the goblet or the bodyweight squat here.